sometimes when you look at data in a spreadsheet, you don't get a real sense of what's going on until you're actually able to see it visually and to see it spatially. One example is we're working with District 65, so that's the public school here in Evanston, looking at their bus structure. So District 65, because of various programs, English as a second language, two-way immersion, magnet schools, they bus students all over Evanston.
GIS was really powerful in that throughout the project, it allowed us to map and visualize the current routes in the real-world context. So one problem that we were facing during the project was to identify which routes are efficient and which ones are not. So by looking at the bus routes, analyzing their geographical service areas, and studying their deviousness, we were able to find a metric of defining their efficiency. There is so much information that we couldn't get from simply processing the data in computational ways. So visualizing geographical data can help me identify trend and pattern, like geographically, in order to make better decisions.
And that, for me, was a very impactful way to use maps to tell a story and to get people to think about their daily operations and how we can do things differently.